Brothers and sisters, what's going on? Okay, I'm gonna make this quick and clear here. You got those who are saying, oh, the age of Aries is already starting. The age of Aries starts on March 21st, and somebody said, oh, well, it ain't gonna be the age of Aries because something about Aquarius. Let me tell you something, nigga. The age is a dimensional shift. All right. Some are getting Age of Aries. Shut up, you fucking whale. Some are getting Age of Aries mixed up with, they're getting mixed up with the astrological chart. The astrological chart is literally out of order. All right. The Age of Aries is a dimensional shift. It's a time shift. Just like we going from the age of Pisces, from the age of Aquarius, all right? These are time shifts. And when you're dealing with time shifts, you're dealing with certain frequencies, certain energies, certain... Shut up, you fucking whale. Certain vibrations, certain frequencies. I understand what's going on. Someone said the age of Aries is starting in December 21st. I'm like, nigga, what the fuck type of shit? You're not timekeepers. Stop trying to act like you know what the shit you're saying, because the age of Aries cannot begin before the eclipse, which is so, like, Brother Marvin and I in Remedy H, we're deep into what we're doing. This is no freaking joke. We're not blurting stuff out there. This is real. As a timekeeper, as I work directly with the Council of Time, Brother Remini H and Marvin work directly with the Council of Time. They deal with time on a different plateau than I deal with time. But we come together and we communicate telepathically, not physically. The Age of Aries is a dimensional shift. All right, it's a shift. When we're in a completely different dimension, all right? And this has nothing to do with the astrological charts. This is the age of power. Aries represents powers. Aries represents war. Aries represents retribution. Aries represents vengeance. Rawr. That's the age of Aries, nigga. So we're coming out of the age of Aquarius. It's the age of information. We're getting out of this knowledge. We're getting everything we need to get. And now we're coming into the age of power. We're going to begin exercising what we learn. And it's not going to take some 100, 200 years for the age of Aquarius. These Saxons lied about everything. Don't believe nothing they put on paper. Believe me. You got to understand what's going on. Everything is shifting. You can feel in the ear. You can feel in the ear. This is the age of black fire. The age of pure power. We're talking pure, unadulterated power. Motherfucker. Sorry, video came. Don't talk, Miss Crucio. Oh, the age of Aries. Someone said the age of Aries is March the 21st. And ain't the age of Aries. Someone said, ain't the age of Aries begin December? It cannot begin before the eclipse, or after. It can't be getting before or after the eclipse. When the eclipse happens, it literally takes us into that age of Aries. It takes us into it. All right? From what's it's going to be to the 4th of April, either the 8th of April, when the eclipse is going to be happening. And it's all the energy is going to add up until the 21st of April. 2024. All right, if you want to go in with numerology, then 2 + 1 = 3 + 4 + 7. All right, and 2024 is gonna give you your number 8. It's 2024 is going to give you number 8. Am I right or wrong? 2024 is going to give you number 8. So it's going to give you number 15. 1 plus 5 is 6. 6 is the symbol of the high angelic power. All right. 6 is the number of high angelic power. So we're in the age of Aries. We're coming into the age of Aries, which is the age of power. You gotta understand, during this age here, we're talking about a lot of information that's gonna be coming down in your thoughts. Your thoughts play a role, all right? It's important that you understand that you begin to exercise on a completely different principle. You begin to see things in a completely different knowledge. Understand what's going on, brothers and sisters. So let's get ourselves together. Because we coming in the power. Now, the power is not just going to come to you. You have to work towards that power. It's something that you're going to have to desire. It's not something you know this power going to hit you. Nothing's going to land in your lap. No. If you don't put work towards it, like I'm doing with these videos, if you don't move into it, nothing's coming to you. Just let you know now. Or like any time. We're going to get this, you're going to do this, you got to do a little bit or a lot of work. Because a little bit goes towards a lot. Because just like our ancestors worked towards the power they had, you got to work the same way. Don't think that you're going to be get some kind of special treatment just because we went some bullshit or you're biracial or Latino or black. You got to work for your power just like your ancestors worked for that power. They did all the rituals, they did all the different works that they had to do, the self-work. In order for them to get where they were. All right. Just to let you guys know, it's going to be the age of power. You're going to have to work towards that power. Lots of meditation, lots of self work, lots of understanding of who you are. I mean, there's a shitload of fangs that literally are going to be taking place. And you got to get ready for this power. Alright, the age of Aries hasn't started already. So stop putting that shit out there. Because you got no idea what's going on. You're not a timekeeper. You're not sitting in the councils of the galactic. You're not sitting in the galactic council. You're not. You have no idea what's going on. You're throwing stuff out there that you're literally making yourself look like a fucking idiot. I'm serious. Age of Aries cannot start for the eclipse. The eclipse is what takes us into that shit. That eclipse is literally gonna do this. The age of Aries cannot start before the eclipse. So just share that with you all, and I'll catch you guys a little bit later.